specified something here.
This is going to be very hard to watch, but we are going to stay here. So if you cannot keep watching, you're going to just simply have to turn off the TV. This is very, very serious. And hyenas do fight fiercely amongst different clans, and sometimes even within their own clan. And it's often the females that will compete most ferociously for the hierarchy of queen. And it looks like right now, one individual hyena is in serious trouble. It's one ear is just about being ripped off. And like I said, this isn't easy to... I know this is incredibly difficult. I'm just trying to gather myself here. This poor hyena is in such a terrible state. It was calling out there. I know we were hoping to show you hyena audio, but not in such a desperate affair like this, with the one calling out, hoping that possibly the rest of its clan will come out and rescue it. Its back left foot is severely wounded. And a lot of you may be wondering why it's not running off, and I think it's because it is in such bad shape that it simply cannot move. Oh, it's such tricky business. We don't know what's going on here with all these hyena. This hyena is certainly going to lose its left ear. Imagine the pain it's in. Like I said earlier, it's also got terrible wounds on its back left foot. And I'm guessing that a lot of that back pad and toes have been ripped off. If they wanted to kill this hyena, it would be very easy for the five adults that are here, let alone these three sub-adults that are all sniffing around it now. Five adults plus these three sub-adults would be no match for this one hyena. And that's why it's just sitting here, hoping that they do not actually stick through with their attack and their assault. Like I said, I'm not too sure why this hyena has caught itself on the wrong side of the fence, but this individual may have perpetrated some kind of a crime to receive this punishment. Maybe not. Maybe it was just unlucky in the wrong place at the wrong time. Let's see if it tries to move here. Yeah, it looks like it's going to. Oh, no. Yeah, okay, it's back. Its back foot has been completely broken. So I'll take back what I've just said. This hyena is in dire straits. It wasn't a one-sided battle, and maybe, just maybe, that this is where a territorial warfare or war took place between many hyena from two clans. And maybe the Djuma clan was the successful clan to win, but one soldier from the neighboring clan got left behind. Look at those wounds. I mean, that's a two-sided fight, that, and I think we are sitting in the middle of a battle zone from last night, and sadly, I'm not enjoying it either. My heart is obviously feeling huge desperation and sorrow for this wounded individual, but it's our job simply to spectate, Archer, and try and understand these animals a bit better. I've never ever seen anything like this between hyena. I've seen wild dog fighting with hyena several times. Lions chasing hyena chasing leopard. But you see, interaction between hyena like this is very, very unique. And even though it is hard to watch, we are all very, very privileged to be experiencing and witnessing this, because again, we are very seldom out to experience these rare phenomenons, even the gory ones that are quite sad and hard to watch, can provide us with very important info regarding the species. That fear is just wrenching my soul out. We can't help you. Its back foot is absolute jelly. Oh, sorry. You are not in good shape, are you? Like I said again, not easy, but at least it is on the move. Oh, no. That back foot is just too much. And I have seen animals survive from the worst of injuries, but this is absolutely next level. Now, I'm guessing that this is the sub-adult following its mother back to its rightful home. Hard to say, though. But the fact that one sub-adult is following the adult back indicates to me that it's more likely a female than a male. So maybe it was an inter-clan dispute. So, I mean, judging by the direction that she's heading in, she's heading straight back into Djuma. And this poor old cub probably doesn't know what to do to console its adult. And the fact that this cub was tolerated by all the other hyena members, but its mother wasn't, it's just hard to understand. You will sometimes get an individual who has enough of the hierarchy and try and upstage or upthrow or overthrow a current queen. So that's what may have happened here.